developments of the hall, which as you may be aware is very much not our regular venue. So my thanks for your understanding and patience while members have actually been able to act as you and well to fight this dog session. Terms of practical arrangements for no fire on the schedule, therefore along with the sound, I take note of the details of the present and will ensure you are supported safely from the premises. We don't have any microphones present today, therefore you will know that it's quite a large room, so can people speak clearly for the purposes of everyone here. At this stage as well, can we also ask members to introduce themselves clearly because we are being recorded by members of the court. So that's quite it. Thank you.
Taking over the role of chair. No, Brian's attending the office. not in the minutes of the last meeting. Item two. Any matters arising? Page 5, page 1, page 2, page 3, page 4, page 5, page 6, and page 7. Can we then agree in the minutes?
Agree.
Thank you. Can I then move on to item 3, the call to report, and ask the Cllr if she wants to introduce that for us.
Thank you, Chair. Morning, members. The purpose of this quarterly committee report is to provide members of enforcement work, projects, training, and promotional work that's been undertaken by Mersey Poor Health Authority during the period of the 1st of April to the 30th of June 2018. In relation to budget information, members will see that there is just a slight increase, very minor, in terms of the revenue that's been generated in the official checks that were undertaken at the port. In particular, in terms of the CF charges which relate to the foods of non-animal origin, members will see that there has been an increase there due to the products that are coming through the port. And then throughout the table, in terms of income, it is quite consistent. In relation to point 2.3, official imported food checks, we continue to receive a number of queries relating to imported food, and during the quarter, the authority received 4,179 imported food-related queries. With regards to the consignments relating to products of animal origin, there has been a small increase during quarter one, which is consistent correlation of the figures throughout the year, the quarter-one period. In relation to FNAO, again, foods of non-animal origin, members will see there has also been a steady increase of consignments coming through the port in relation to them. And in relation to other foods, we had a slight decrease. However, from the previous quarter period before, you can see that there has been a considerable increase of queries related to other types of food coming through the port. In relation to samples taken, we had a number of 25 samples taken that were satisfactory, and one sample that was unsatisfactory. Details of that is detailed in the table on the following page. Products that failed was a consignment of fish meal due to microbiological examination. In relation to rejected consignments, we had two foods of non-animal origin consignments rejected and one product of animal origin consignment rejected, and details of that is also detailed in the table below. Primarily for the POAO, it was because it was for an approval number that had been omitted, which is a legal requirement on the food product, and so that was an immediate rejection. And in relation to the foods of non-animal origin consignments, it contained an ingredient that's from an approved country to import into the UK. So that was destroyed. With regards to international health regulations, officers continue to fulfill 100% of requests for ship sanitation inspections that arrive in the port, issuing 37 ship sanitation exemptions and 2 ship sanitation control certificates, requiring remedial action on the vessel to comply with international health regs. During the quarter, the authority did investigate one incident of communicable disease outbreak on board a vessel, and remedial control measures were applied, and the outbreak was contained strictly to the vessel. Port Health officers processed in action 691 ship arrival information submissions, and we also continue to conduct shellfish monitoring at the beds that fall within the jurisdiction. Well, officers continue to attend meetings representing the authority, and we still continue to hold the student training days, one being imported food and the other being international health regulations. That's quite a short, concise report, members. I'm inviting any questions relating to the report.
Sure.
Just a quick one from Cllr on the shellfish. Any of the beds open yet?
At the moment, we are monitoring the beds. Yesterday, when officers are carrying samples, the beds vary in terms of, I mean, obviously, this is 3 months ago, so at the moment, during that period, we don't have any beds that was open, we're just doing monitoring. And the beds will be dependent on whether they're actually commercially viable for coupling at the moment. And at the moment, there isn't any.
Just on the back of that, the decision to open beds is not our decision. It's an if call.
Yes, Northwest UK.
Yeah, Northwest UK will make a decision whether to open beds. I'm not aware that they can't file the beds at the moment. That's the situation where we are. We have a case of illegal attempt to harvest and that was in the Wirral recently, but that was dealt by also officer trying to go back and went out and dealt with that. Yes.
Yes, thank you. Just a very simple question as a new member of the committee. What's the difference between irregular and unsatisfactory samples?
Unsatisfactory occurs when we sample it and we discover maybe a known contaminant that affects the food. Irregular could be something like labelling issue on the product, and we would then refer that in.
Thank you. Thanks, Ron. Thank you, Kev. The fish meal that failed microbiological contamination, can you expand a little bit on that, and could you say what possible outcomes could happen to have that on the impact?
Usually with the fish meal, with the nature of the product, it's very common for it to be contaminated with salmonella. So usually we will do tests for salmonella. When it fails, you can actually treat the product and eradicate the salmonella, which usually is what happens, and that's the reason why it doesn't reject it.
Thank you.
Just one further.